It's really an honor to have you here, Frank, and that you can speak about this convention. We try in Israel to implement and to give our best in cooperation with UEFA, and I think it's a really first highlight of the conference. Very warm welcome, and the floor, Frank, is yours.
Thank you very much, Willy, for these kind words. First of all, I'd like to address Mr. Hassan, Mr. Fröhlich, also Nissim Bachar. I'm really glad that all of you are present in this opening session. For me personally, it is a great pleasure to be with you. We are all in very difficult and challenging times, as it was underlined already just before. We need to cope. We need to go new ways. Online education has been over the last months really more explored. More and more national associations are really going new ways. Innovation is really requested. We did the same at UEFA level, at in various contexts, educational contexts. We have launched a new Football in Schools program and went online as soon as it was no longer possible to organize all of the events on site. But now let's have a quick look. This was the request of Willy Rothensteiner and the entire technical team. Let's have a quick look at the coaching convention, where we are coming from, what has been modified in recent times, and in which direction we will go in the future. Also, one word on the video that you saw already before. We are not going to show this at this stage, and you also can skip the CV. Just move on to the next slide. You saw the highlights from UEFA's competitions, and that is also reflecting what I just said before. New ways, innovative, but what we all would like to see as soon as possible is that we can have again spectators in the stadium. That is so crucial. I mean, last night again, Champions League in front of empty stadia, there is something missing. And we all want that back. And hopefully this crisis will be overcome in the near future. So I'm responsible now after 23 years. You could also call me a dinosaur, but I'm responsible for a very comprehensive technical development program, and that comprises the coaching program, including the coaching convention. There's also a grassroots program, grassroots charter. We organize conferences, workshops, seminars on a regular basis for various coaching target groups. We have strengthened everything that we do in terms of match and performance analysis, and we have various levels of exchange programs. Can you go to the next one, please, Boaz? But we have to say, I mean, I just mentioned the 23 years that I'm working for UEFA, but it has been in general a long way through the tunnel for the coaching convention to be there where we are today. It is not something that is happening from one day to another. We can go to the next slide, please. There were a lot of challenges over the years. The kickoff was given in 1991, when the UEFA Executive Committee, believe it or not, had a meeting in New York. It was an extraordinary meeting connected to a FIFA event at the time. But at that time, the green light was given to create a coaching convention. And to have this political backing was extremely important. But it took, again, a number of years, and now we can move to the next slide. It took a number of years until the signing of the coaching convention contract. You can click, Boaz. There were, at the beginning in 1998, there were six associations to sign the coaching convention. And these six were considered to be leading in the field of coach education. And they helped to design the minimum criteria of this very important document and fill it with life. We can move on, please. So there were a lot of challenges over the years, and you can continue with the animation wars. There were a lot of challenges. The former Soviet Union broke up, and also the Balkan, the former Yugoslavia, a lot of new individual associations were created, and they all needed support. And they got the support from UEFA, namely through the UEFA JIRA panel. Boaz, can you click on the animation, please? Yes, one more. Yes, thank you. And that took a while, a number of years, but there was a big, big willingness to help, to assist, to monitor, and to share the own experience. We can move on, please. So at one stage, the Football Federation of Israel also received endorsement, and it started, or it was a step-by-step process with the B&A license in 2005 and the pro license then in 2007. And only 10 years later, the Elite Youth A license was approved as well. And there are more challenges to come, but we talk about it later. Just please go on with the slides. So very long and concise project. I'm not going to go through all the different milestones. One important one was certainly also the introduction of UEFA club licensing, because the club licensing really made the coaching qualifications obligatory and then had a knock-on effect on what the national associations were doing also in terms of club licensing. And that was extremely helpful to introduce this. There were a number of phases of development, but we can continue to the next slide, please. So in 2020, then the launch of the new convention. We can move on, please. But let's have a look at, I will come back to the new convention in a second, the benefits of the coaching convention. I think over the years, we have really improved the coaching standards at all levels. We have minimum criteria, and this is always important to highlight, that there's not only one way. We want to encourage the associations to have their own philosophy, understanding of football, also reflected in coach education. But minimum criteria are important to ensure that there is also mutual recognition. We have now the C license as part of the process. There is an enhanced coach education pathway. We were looking already before, but now even more into specialist coach education. And through this comprehensive program, we really protect and better develop the players. There's also better and transparent exchange between all national associations. So this is mutual beneficial, and there are a lot of more further education opportunities like this very event. The courses have been improved over the years. The status of the coach is really much stronger than it was 20 years ago. The diplomas, licenses are mutually recognized as UEFA diplomas and licenses. There are specific templates existing, mutual recognition, I mentioned before, and we ensure through this convention cross-border movement, not only within the borders of the European Union, but far beyond. As you know, UEFA has 55 national associations, and we are in line, however, with the European law. That was always also a crucial point for us. Can move on. So the convention has never been set in stone. It was a review process over the years in a regular rhythm. We are in a 5-year rhythm, and you can click one more time. Yeah. So when we created the 2015 version, we had based ourselves on an independent research study that was conducted through Leeds Beckett University at the time. It was a huge consultation process with all our stakeholders. And this really helped us to get the focus right for the next 5 years. And now we had again a very critical eye, critical look at the coaching convention. And in March, our UEFA Executive Committee has approved the version, the latest version. distribution has taken place to all member associations, and all associations have ratified the document in the meantime, so it is operational. You can move on, please. These are the guardians of the coaching convention, and right in the middle behind me, you can also see Mr. Ruttensteiner, who is a prominent member of this group. All these members are experienced coach educators in their respective national associations. So it is really important that we can rely on such big expertise. The aims of the new convention now is really to further improve course standards, and then very critical as well, to link the worlds of education and employment by developing the coach's competence in realistic situations. And this is really reflected in all the guidelines that have been elaborated. The coaching pathway is further enhanced. We have now reiterated the importance of a skilled coach educator workforce. The coach educator is crucial. If you don't invest into the qualification of the coach educators, how can you think that you are really in a position to produce high-level coaches? Then we have, of course, inserted all the recent amendments. Also in between these five-year milestones, we are in a position to adapt and modify. We have then introduced the new C-Diploma. The C-Diploma is now mandatory. The C-Diploma is the grassroots coach education, and we need to nurture the grassroots of the game. And then we have filled two more gaps. One was below the elite youth A license. We have now created a youth B license, and below the goalkeeper A license, a goalkeeper B level has now been introduced. And as we speak now, an evaluation process is already taking place to get associations into these qualifications. There are a lot of enhanced opportunities for non-resident candidates. It makes it even more flexible to move also from one association to another. These coach educator qualifications become now mandatory within the next 3 years. Very important. But that is the duty. Can you just go back one more time? This is the duty really of the national associations. And we had a very critical look also at the further education policy. And we hope that we are able to influence the national associations to make further education even more relevant. And we can move on, please. So this is the first sentence of the coaching convention. That is the vision. The vision is to set high coach education standards to improve the quality of coach education in all UEFA member associations, with the aim of developing better coaches and ultimately, of course, better players and the overall quality of the game. In having this vision, obviously, we also want to be a reference for the world. And Willy Ruttensteiner mentioned it, the work that we are doing has very much influenced in recent times all our sister confederations. I'm personally also in a working group with FIFA and the confederations. We had just before yesterday night another discussion about worldwide coach education. We can move on, please. This is then the enhanced pathway. I mentioned that the green boxes are the new diplomas that I just mentioned before. And here you can see where exactly they sit, and you have an overview of the hours of education and still connections to the grassroots leader certificate below the core educational pathway. We can move on, please. These are the figures. You can click one more time, Boaz. The thing here is that we have now roughly 180,000 qualified coaches on BA Pro and the specialized A elite youth A and goalkeeper B across Europe. The weak point are the qualified female coaches. Only 6% of them are qualified. We have here one colleague from Israel who participated in recent times in UEFA's Pro License Student Exchange Program, but many more are needed, and therefore we have developed specific offers. We have scholarships for women and much more. We can move on. Very complementary are our exchange programs. And here again, you see UEFA share with roughly 1,000 participants every year. For the time being, everything online in this season. We have canceled so many on-site events, but hopefully in the next year, we can tackle this again. And coach education is prominent with specific subtopics like fitness for football, futsal coach educators, goalkeeper coach educators, and then also connected to the mandatory, future mandatory coach educator qualification, the development of these, where we also try to help our associations. We can move on, please. This is the pro license student exchange, also very complementary. We have had 36 events since 2011. This is an opportunity also for UEFA to have direct impact on the new generation of coaches, and the coaches on the other side can get access to UEFA instructors, tutors, content, and they can experience the House of European Football, which is also not neglectable. Can move on. This was the last group that we had, but we can just continue, please. The digital technical reports, a lot of changes and upgrades have been done. They are all accessible online. We just finished the last report in the last days. So that was the report on the Youth League, UEFA Youth League, but UCL, UEL, everything is done. Also the Women's Champions League, there is a really nicely accessible platform now. You can also go back in history and look at the technical reports that were done in the past, and you will also notice the changes. The video material is fantastic. We have new tactical coaching cameras, and there are graphics and video available for everybody. This is the timeline of the technician, our technical newsletter, which is incorporated now in UEFA Direct, our magazine, but there are interesting topics, and I can only recommend you to have a look at it. Again, everything available online. We can move on. This was a technician timeline, but we can continue. We have a planning done. Now, a quick look at the future. Nothing is set in stone, as I said. We can continue, Boaz. We have identified focus areas where we offer specific events, material, and so on. And these are three areas that we are currently directly nurturing. On the one side, the educational pathway, the coach educator development, and we still again and again work on reality-based methodology, and now also in the context of the assessment exercises. Please, can you move on? So the mutual impact, if you have an enhanced coach education pathway together with the correct methodology, you will have a better learning experience. Boaz, the next, please. And if the pathway is connected to more and good coach educators, you will produce more coaches. And one more, please. And if you have better coach educators, the better methodology, you will produce better coaches. This is the roadmap of support. Very important it is for us to bring together all the leaders of coach education every 3 years. We had the last one last year in Cyprus, where we discussed the latest trends and the focus areas with all our coach education stakeholders. And everything that we do, that we offer, needs to be carried on the shoulders of the national associations. And that is really important. Then the launch of the, can you go back, please? The launch of the coaching convention was crucial. And then you have the complementary seminars that we are offering, and not to forget the mentoring and the evaluation, because we are in regular touch with all national associations at the latest every 3 years, or if there's a change of leadership. We really want to monitor and ensure that the quality delivery is still up to date. And this is why this is important. And a final statement, and I think nobody will disagree in this digital room, that the coach is the key to success. And he can only lead to success if he has gone through a well-structured and multi-layered coach education pathway. The convention, we heard it from numerous people across Europe and around the world, has had an impact. It was a massive improvement of coach education delivery on a pan-European scale, and the game as a total has arisen. And there's also evidence in relation to that when you simply look at the results of the last World Cup, where the top teams all came from Europe. This is it from my side. I hope I was not too long, but it was a quick update on where we stand in relation to the coaching convention. And I wish you now a very interesting conference online. I saw the speakers are outstanding. I saw that my friend Roberto Martinez is also speaking. That is great. And also Roger Spry is lined up. Really happy. I hope I will be able to see him. I have some other meetings also coming up, but I will try to stay as long as possible with you. And now I pass the ball directly back into the feet of Mr. Rothensteiner.